John from Lake Erie Chestnuts, finishing up our project. We're going to plant our first few nuts out. It's kind of that May 6th time frame. A little dicey on planting these, but I'm going to trial this to see if they can tolerate a light frost. They don't like hard freezing from what I'm told, but I'm going to try this to see if they get a light frost, because some chestnuts do sprout on their own in this climate. We'll just have to see if it kills the nuts or not. This is an experiment. But first, we're going to take a look. I got a lot of feedback on the air pruning table that I built, and I'm going to show you how I kind of took care of the problem that you saw with the heavy lid. I think it's going to open enough that I can get access without access from doors and so forth, and that's the reason why I did this. It opens at a big mouth. It's tall, and it opens quickly. So let's take a look at that. All right, so the only modification is I put one little triangle piece up on top, a little bit of an angle to give a little more stability, and I put these hinges in place, and we got three of them. They're heavy-duty hinges, but who knows how good they'll do. And then people talked about putting a leg kind of up on the side that could fold down, which is a great idea, but I do have this open area here. Of course, I'm gonna have to kill this multi-flora rose back, but I've got this block here and we're gonna rest it on that. So basically I lift this. It's pretty heavy, but not too heavy. I'm lifting it with one hand here, and you can see it's starting to tilt back. Let's get you to a fisheye, get you a little more of it. You can see it's tilting back. I'm holding it with one hand. It's kind of at that nice little rest area where it's laying back, and then it'll gain a little momentum, but it feels pretty steady. It's not straining. It's not stretching a lot, and I could put the block up to there and maybe make it a little easier to lift, but you can see how wide this mouth gets quickly. So even if I have taller trees, they'll be pretty easy to fold in as I bring it back down, but it might require a second person if I've got a bunch of trees. But I'm gonna lower this back. We're gonna get our first few trees planted here. And it rests nicely right there. So you can see, this is what she looks like all opened up. And my intentions are that after the trees are about a foot to a foot and a half tall, to leave it open. Because by then I'll be able to cut the nut off, let it grow, and birds and so forth won't bother it. They won't bother it once it grows like that. Rabbits shouldn't hop up in there. And as long as the nut is gone, I won't have trouble with squirrels and birds. So let's get to planting. This is Empire Elite Mix that I potted up on the 28th of November. And these are the 3x8 containers that I'm gonna put it in. So I'll get those set up here. You see some are even sprouting, even though they're in the fridge and in the dark, because I'm late getting planted. I didn't bring near enough planters to plant everything today. Just gonna do this trial, and then I'll be planting around Memorial Day. I'll be planting heavily. So I brought some soil. I don't even know if I brought enough soil for these pots. I can see these are about an inch above the table height. So I'll have to be careful I don't come down and smash that as the lid, you know, doesn't fit exactly square. It's raining out here today. So a good rainy day project. I thought about putting these in flats, but the flats that these come with that you purchase for them have a little tilt to them, so then your plant has a slight tilt as opposed to where the roots sit. So I'm planting them directly on the hardware cloth. One thing I thought that I might put on the bottom to keep the dirt from falling through the bottom as I fill these, because they do have a hole in the bottom, pretty good size, is put a little landscape fabric down. I cut some off of a roll. It's about 3 foot wide, so I had to cut couple little strips here to go along the edge, and then I'll get these all set up and I'll fill them up with dirt, get the seed put in. You've seen, if you've watched my videos, you see that I typically have the nut on top, because I'm exposing them to the weather here, I'm gonna put the nut in the soil. So we'll see how that all works out. See you back after I get the pots all set up. Have you seen the price of Miracle-Gro this year? I'm going with a different soil. I've used this before. I prefer the Miracle-Gro potting mix, but this is Expert Gardener. Just a generic cheapo from, I believe, Walmart. I bought in February or so. Thought today would be a good day because we got the sky already watering our plants for us. We got enough dirt to start a few of them. We'll get the seeds and get going. I'm going to put a support so some of these don't tip over. Put a couple bricks up against that until I get the whole table set up with plants. There'll be some leaning a little bit as the hardware cloth has just a little bit of a buckle in it, I guess. It's not perfectly flat. Not bad. Here's my nuts going into the experiment. Will they do okay? Well, the intentions are to cover these up with a little bit of soil. When you let them go too long, the roots do get long, and you got to be careful with them. That one's not bad. You just don't want to break that off if you don't have to. You've seen me plant these millions of times. I either use a pencil or my finger to make a spot for the root. If you push too hard, you can snap that root off, and it'll often, as long as there's a little bit of root there, it'll usually survive, but you'd prefer to leave some of that tap on there. This one's got a sprout up already. I'll leave that a little exposed. It's going to be cloudy and rainy the next couple days. If it gets a little sunburnt, usually we'll survive that. If there's a long, curly, dry end on the root, I just kind of pinch that off. The trees do just fine without. This is what I mean when you get kind of a really long tail, it's hard to plant. And I've had just fine success snapping that off. They work, they grow just fine. You can't tell them apart in the orchard. At least I can't. But if you try to put that whole thing down and you just put a little too much on it, it'll snap off one of the connections to the nut and then you're in trouble. Again, see that woody end? I don't know if that's coming in clear or not, but if I go to try to put that curl in, there's a little curl there that you can see. That will catch on something and it can snap one of these two connections to the nut. And, you know, less connection to the nut, less feeding, more problems. Not saying it can't survive, but I've had much better luck just snapping that off. Again, I'll show you I can link to where I had built the one with the horse manure. It's on the opposite side here. That didn't have a top. I thought mice would be my main problem, but birds, I think, got in there. Or maybe mice climbed to clear the top and squirrels and then just went down through the top. That's why I did a top this time, because they uprooted and killed many of my seedlings. That was a couple years ago I did that experiment, and I still grow trees there, but I plant them after I have them sprouted. This one's got a double root coming out of it, and if you have a few nuts, you can try to make two trees out of it, but I am not going to do that. I'm going to kill the one. It had a double embryo, just snapped one off. We'll let it go with the one. So usually I'd leave them like this inside, but I'm gonna cover the nut just with the weather and that they're being exposed to potentially freezing temperatures, not in the forecast, but just a possibility, as we're not past our historic frost date. You can see some of them have that sprout already going. They're gonna get watered in by nature today. Now you can see all these nuts here. Got a lot of them. Got to do this a lot more times. But we'll put these back in the truck. So fitting about 15 in actual practice here across. So we didn't get all 15, but two times 14, 28. 13 more is 41. And maybe about 50 trees planted here today. Now let's see how she closes down without pinching this, I hope. I think the edge being up a little may pinch a little, depending on if I can keep it square. Well, I double tapped the video, so I came out here after turkey hunting and doing a terrible job of that, and thought I'd finish up a film of we're gonna close this. It did close just fine, but I double tapped the video, so we didn't video it yesterday. But you can see that this pulls shut, takes a little lift there, get it going. And then I do have to kind of skew it a little bit just to get it to miss there a little bit on the pots, and we can just knead it up. So there they are, all protected from mice, birds, squirrels. They look like they're doing okay. I'll come out here later this week, water them if it need be, if there's no rain. But anyway, hope you like this video. If you like it, give it a thumbs up. We're close to 3,000 subs. Maybe you can be the 3,000. We'll see you next time. Remember, if you're not growing, you're dying.